little Blake Shelton to help you wake up on this Monday. And one of Atlanta's most iconic hotels has a whole hive of workers most people never even see. But the bees up on the hotel's roof are sweetening the stay for each and every guest. And Good Day Atlanta's Paul Milliken is live at the Atlanta Marriott Marquis this morning. And Paul, there is nothing better than honey for breakfast, my favorite. Good morning.
No.
The honey, not you.
I know it is.
Right?
So, Elise, this is what viewers need to know, Elise. Oh, that, you're so mean. I was going to bring you back something, and now you just ruined it, Elise. So, what viewers need to know is anytime I'm anywhere where there's honey, I get a text from Elise while she's anchoring saying, bring me back some.
It's true.
Look at that, my friend. Look at that right there. This could all be yours if you're very nice to me. And here's what's cool was that this honey comes from the bees that are on the roof here at the Atlanta Marriott Marquis. It is fascinating that here in the middle of downtown Atlanta, in this urban cityscape, we've got beekeeping going on, and this is one of the guys that's up there working with the bees, the sous chef Jason. How are you, man?
I'm well. How are you?
It's great to see you. I'm happy to be here at Sear. It's a beautiful restaurant. So let's talk first of all about the bees. What's it like working with the bees up there?
Oh, it's so cool. It was a refreshing experience when it first started, and when I first got up there, yeah. And I got to work with them. At first, it was it's full of adrenaline. You know, you have those bees flying over you. You don't know if they're gonna sting you.
It's a little
crazy at first, but it's really cool.
Yeah, and the best part is that you get the honey, and then you get to use it down here in Sear. So what are some of the things you'll use the honey for?
So we use it for the parfait. We do this in the mornings. Mm-hmm. It's we use some fresh berries in there, some house-made granola. We make it in-house.
Nice.
And then, of course, the yogurt.
Yep.
And we'll top it with some honey.
Yeah.
And then for lunch, we'll go into a flatbread. We do a flatbread with heirloom tomatoes. It's got the honey on top.
Oh, wow.
It's feta cheese. It just sets it off really well.
Nice.
And then for dinner, we put it in salads. We put it in dressings. We put it in all kinds of wonderful stuff.
I love that. For you as a chef, it must be so gratifying to know that the ingredients you're putting into the food, I mean, you know exactly where it comes from. I mean, you are that hands-on with it.
Absolutely. And that's what about probably 95% of our products we make in-house or we build in-house. So it's wonderful knowing exactly where your food comes from.
Well, sir, you know I'm not going to stand in a kitchen without eating something. So will you please make me a parfait or something?
Absolutely.
All right, let's do it. So tell me what you're doing here. What's in the parfait?
So this is a whipped cream canister, and it's got the yogurt and a little bit of cream to just make it fluff up a little
bit.
And then we'll just top it off with my honey, Chef Danny.
Ooh,
there we go.
Yeah, there it is right there.
I'm going to top it with some of this fresh honey.
Wow. And again, that is really honey straight from the hive.
Absolutely.
Wow, that is so neat. Let's
see if I can get this in here.
Beautiful. Oh. And simple as that. I guess have got to love it when you tell them that this comes from bees, because people wouldn't even know it was up there.
Exactly. And we talk to them about it. We try to stress it as much as we can so that everybody knows about it, because we want to make sure that everybody's working on some sustainability.
Yeah. And tell me real quick before I eat and drink and, you know, demolish the food that's here. For folks who have never been to Sear before, how would you describe the cuisine? What do you do in here?
So it's a American fire-inspired grill. So we work a lot with the fire. We have a great grill over here. We do a lot of steaks for dinner. Mm-hmm. For breakfast, you know, we bring in a lot of people for breakfast, a lot of omelets and stuff like that. They're wonderful. Everything from scratch.
Yeah.
And then for lunch, it's just we have a lot of fresh stuff, a lot of really cool things, a lot of seasonal, and we're working on making sure that everything is very seasonal.
Yeah, and we should mention too, as you saw in the first hour, there's an herb garden up there, and the herbs come right down to the food too, so it's such a neat kind of self-contained operation. All right, time for me to do a little taste testing, and actually, although I'm going to eat the parfait, Elise, you know, for us, it's like lunchtime, right?
That's
I mean,
true.
We've been at work since 3 o'clock in the morning, so I'm going straight for the pizza. Tell me again what all is on my flatbread pizza here. This, so of course, got the honey on it.
So you've got a house-made focaccia bread to start with, and then you've got the heirloom tomato sliced nice and thin, the honey of course, and then you have some feta cheese, and that saltiness from the feta just sets it off.
It's amazing. It's beautiful, sir. Thank you.
Thank you.
And thank you, bees upstairs, for giving me this wonderful gift. So good. Oh, and I also, honey is used in the cocktails too, so this is a breakfast cocktail.
You are so lucky. Okay, we expect you to come back.
Elise,
cheers. Nice and sticky from eating all that honey. Love it. All right, Paul, thank you. We already know the Halloween traditions like dressing up, collecting candy, and carving pumpkins, but do you know how they all started or how they've changed over the years? Well, Paul will take us to the Douglas County Museum of Art and of History and Art for a new exhibit with all of those answers. And it is that time of year. It's kind of hard to believe. Let's check in with meteorologist Joanne Feldman in the Fox 5 Storm Center.